you grind out stale grounds before dosing your portafilter? You know, run the grinder for a couple seconds to push out any grounds that were retained from last time and then just throw them away? Hey, espresso lovers, Marc here from Whole Latte Love. It's something I often do, and depending on the grinder you're using and how you use it, it may be the only way to be certain you're getting a completely fresh dose. So I have 7 well-known grinders here, and I tested each to see how much ground coffee it retains after grinding. I'll have detailed results of my tests in a minute. There were a couple of surprises, so be sure and stick around for that. I'll also have some usage tips and opinions, things I picked up when working with the 7 grinders side by side for a day. First, a quick look at the grinders and then details on the testing procedure. So, the competitors in order from lowest price to most expensive, we have the Rock Manual starting things off. It's an easy-to-use hand-powered unit with a grind straight-through design and stepless grind size adjustment. Next, the Baratza Sette 270. It grinds straight through like the Rock, but the motor makes it easier and, of course, a little faster. 2 more Barattas after that, the Vario and the Forte. For years, the Vario has been recommended by many as the entry grinder into higher-end home grinding for espresso. Forte is similar to the Vario, but uses a more powerful motor and has a more robust and durable full metal case. The Mazur Mini is an Italian grinder that's been around for a while, and I'll be using the Electronic A version. The ECM V-Titan 64 is made in Germany and features titanium-coated burrs. And last up, the Chiato E37S, like the Mazur, it's made in Italy. The E37S was updated for 2017 and features the largest burr set of the group at 83 millimeters. It uses Chiato Steady Lock technology and is known for producing very consistent dosing weights. To test the grinders, I first dialed each into a grind size that produced a standard double espresso from an 18-gram coffee dose in 20 to 30 seconds from first drip. Then I meticulously cleaned the grinders using a variety of tools, including brushes, some pokers, and a vacuum. Although laborious, it was relatively easy to do the cleaning and maintain the grind setting on all but 2 of the grinders. The Rock Manual grinder was a breeze with its straight-through design and nothing to take apart. Same for the straight-through Sette 270 with an easy-to-twist-out burr assembly. The Vario and the Forte were fairly simple with their top burr that removes using a custom tool. On the Chiato, it's just 3 screws and you're in with no loss of grind setting when you put things back together. With the ECM V-Titan and the Mazur Mini, it was a little more challenging to open them up for cleaning and then reassemble while maintaining the grind setting. To do that, I made note of the grind setting, then found the zero grind setting by operating the grinder and turning the adjustment until the burrs touch. I then noted the angle of rotation made between my dialed-in grind size and the zero grind setting. After cleaning and reassembly, I returned the grinders to their zero setting and backed them off by the angle of rotation noted prior to taking them apart. Now, all that sounds a little complex, but it's actually much easier than it sounds. With the grinders cleaned and set back to the dialed-in grind size, I weighed out 18 grams of beans, accurate to 1/100th of a gram. Now, at times I was literally splitting beans to nail the 18 grams on the scale. Those beans were then single-dosed into a grinder, and the grinder was run until no more ground coffee exited the grinder. What came out was then weighed. This process of cleaning, calibrating, grinding, and weighing was repeated 3 times on each grinder. Now, a couple of notes on the procedure. I used Maroma's Arabia coffee from the same bag for all the tests. When practical, any ground coffee that was easily accessible by a brush in areas like a chute were brushed out and included in the final weights. And if you try these tests at home, you may see slightly different results based on variables like coffee type, humidity, static, and other factors. So here are the results showing the average weight dispensed for the 3 grind cycles done on each grinder. They're ordered here from best to worst, taking top honors, the least expensive grinder in the bunch, the Rock Manual with an average of 17.68 grams dispensed. The worst performer was the Mazur Mini, which dispensed an average of 14.8 grams, meaning it retained an average of 3.2 grams. In this group, the Mazur is a real outlier. Now, why is that? Well, it's a design that's been around for a while. In the Mazur, there's a lot of space between the burr and the walls of the grinding chamber, and then a relatively long horizontal space between the chamber and where the coffee falls into the delivery cone. An anti-clumping screen in there kind of holds coffee back as well. For the other six grinders, based on my testing, it's fair to consider them all zero retention grinders for practical purposes. Keep in mind that a half gram of old coffee makes up only about 3% of an 18 gram dose. And I'm going to challenge anyone to pick up a difference in flavor from that 3% in a blind taste test. Now, grind retention is, of course, just one measure of a grinder's performance. Other factors include grind quality, dosing accuracy, ease of use, duty cycle, cost, and more. For me, the big takeaway here is that with the exception of the Mazur, you don't need to grind out and throw away coffee to get a fresh dose from any of the other grinders. Now, if you have any questions on this video or anything coffee, be sure and use those comments and I'll get you the answers. I'm Marc from Whole Latte Love. Thanks for watching. And if you haven't, be sure and subscribe and come back for more of the best on everything coffee brought to you by Whole Latte Love. Want to learn more? Subscribe now so you'll know about the latest videos on everything coffee from Whole Latte Love.